Hi, I'm Mark Farber, and this is the Accounting Fundamentals videos. Today we're going to talk about the accounting equation, which is really the central focus of all accounting. It's what all accounting is based off of. And it's nothing more than this very simple little equation over here. Assets equals liabilities plus equity. Well, what does that mean? Well, in order to understand what the equation tells us and why it's so important, we have to understand what the three components are. So first off, assets. Assets are something that a company owns, in the simplest way of putting it. It's really, we could say it's claims that a company has on something. And I'll explain what that means in a second. So things that a company would own would include things like cash in the bank or cash in a cash register. It would include things like equipment, buildings, land. And put in land over here, as well as inventory. If it's a store that sells stuff, and the things that are on the shelves would be the inventory that it's going to sell. It's also, as I said, claims. And what we mean by claims is if the company has lent out money, or if it's done work and it's owed payment. When you do that, when a company provides a good or provides a service and is owed the money, that's called an account receivable. And that's also an asset because eventually when the company receives that money, it's going to be cash, which is an asset. Okay, so that's assets. Liabilities, on the other hand, are amounts that the company owes. Okay, think of that as bank loans, mortgages, different types of loans. But also, if the company purchases something and has not yet paid for it, that would be an account payable. So account payable, okay? And those are amounts that the company owes to banks or to any form of creditor. Equity, the third part of the equation, is essentially the difference between assets and liabilities. So it's the amount of the assets or the value of the assets that ultimately accrues to the owners, to the shareholders of the business. Think of it as selling off all of the assets to get cash, taking that cash and paying back all the money that you owe, and then whatever is left over is the equity in the business. But the other way that we can think about equity is by breaking it into its components. And essentially its components are this. In a sole proprietorship, so a business with just one owner, equity is made up of investments, so money that the owner has put into the business. It's made up of revenue, money that the company earns from doing whatever it is it does. Expenses, so this is plus investments, plus revenue, minus expenses, so that's expenditures that were made in order to earn revenue, and then finally, minus withdrawals, so money that's taken out by the owner from the business. And revenue minus expenses is, of course, profit. So we can think of equity as being the money that the owner has put into the business, plus any profit that the company has earned, minus any withdrawals, any money that the owner has taken out of the business to pay for his own whatever. And so now when we look at this equation, what it really tells us is that the assets, everything that the company owns, is paid for either by borrowing money, incurring a liability, or by adding to the investments or making money. Essentially, it's paid for out of profits. Okay, so now we understand how the company is paying for all the stuff that it owns over here. And this, as I said, is the fundamental part of accounting. This equation always, always, always has to be in balance. Anytime we do anything in accounting, we have to make sure that this is in balance. And that's what we're going to see as we go through the next few videos where we start to look at transactions and how we record them in accounting, essentially. So stay tuned for that in our next discussion where we're going to talk about transactions.